had two amazing candidates come through. So, and thank you to you, Mr. Phillips, for doing all of that legwork and getting everybody together and providing us with a slate of amazing people to choose from. It's been, it's heartwarming to see the number of people that are interested in coming to lead our district, and I think we have two excellent candidates. And it's going to make a very difficult choice, I think, for us tonight. So what I would like to do first, I think, is to have everybody go around and say a few things that you liked about each candidate. So it's not saying, you know, that you want to extend an offer to them, to one or the other, just because we've all had different experiences with them. We've, maybe some of us have retained information from the first interview or from their application packet or things like, I've had different conversations like on a school tour. Things that maybe not everybody is aware of because we aren't all together all the time, obviously. So that way everybody can hear everybody's experiences and what they thought they liked. It might jog your memory of, oh yeah, I forgot about that. That's true. I liked that. So we're going to do that first without making any preferences specifically. And again, I will go first because I know some people are still meeting. Nobody likes to ever go first, so I'll just do that. So things in particular that I liked about Ben Kirby. And not all of this is obviously from tonight, it's from all the different interactions that we've had, is I liked that he has small group meetings on a regular basis with board members, you know, two or three people at a time on a consistent basis to keep everybody in the loop, updated, informed, and know what's going on and just build those relationships. I liked one of the things that he said was he wants to honor the past, recognize what works, but also ask, why are we doing this? Does it still serve our needs? that's something that's going to be coming up, I think. Also, he had, in the last interview, he talked about not creating legacy costs. That's, time deficit. That's very important. I liked the fact that he had his own version of a student advisory council, where he had in underrepresented kids that came in for that. It wasn't all the high flying kids that usually get picked. I thought that was a really neat idea.
They self-select.
They self-select either way, yes. I like that he had talked about how he went out and got grants to pay for additional social workers in the schools to help, and to, that he partnered with the community to help families get through the complicated medical. For them to do it, we're doing it in-house. And one of the things that he mentioned tonight was, it was one of the lines in his form, it was about celebrating completed bond projects. I think it's really neat and important to be able to go out and say, look what you guys did with your tax dollars. Like, this is amazing, and be able to show that off. And he had a really strong talk about his with regard to Gary Kinzer, I was really impressed with the emphasis and the focus and on relationships and how that is the building block for everything that he does. Because we talk a lot about building trust and restoring trust in the district and among people, and that can't be done without relationships. So I thought his focus on that was dead on, and that he developed a very intentional plan at Novi to build the culture and started with the staff to hear their voices and make sure they were heard. I liked that. He did a great job of talking about creating and sustaining systems, having things in place so that the district keeps running smoothly and everybody knows what's expected and the system is in place. His equity work, I think he talked about how it was a journey for him, and it's an continuous and ongoing journey, and he's always learning, and the fact that he instituted inclusion week, I thought was kind of a really neat thing. He also acknowledged, as they both did, the mental health needs of students, but I also thought it was nice that he emphasized the mental health needs of staff as well, and that they need to be supported. earlier, he acknowledged about the importance of extracurriculars and how those enrich the student experience and can be seen as an extension of the classroom. I think that he had some really interesting experience that he had in his resume about the experience of having to close two schools and then redistrict, and how it went well because of the relationships that he had built and the communications that he instituted on that. Same with like eliminating the fourth grade camp. It was you know, a beloved program, but it went smoothly because he was able to listen to the teachers first, because they were the ones who said, this is too much. Listen to the teachers, said, okay, I hear what the problem is. They developed an alternative, and then after having done that, went back out to the families and the students and explained why there was going to be this change. As another small thing was, in his dream big one from last interview, this was realistic. It wasn't, if we got rid of all of the Michigan State standards, then we could do this and this and this, which obviously is not the case. He sort of worked within that and said that he wanted to focus on learning rather than